Stop crying.
Quit clapping.
All right, everybody, and now the time has come for Mr. and Mrs. Kukovia. Get your hands together, everybody. Table 8, clap loudly. It's on. Welcome to the wedding celebrations. Join in, everyone, join in. Don't be shy, get up there. That was close.
So they're going to be going straight into their cake pudding after this.
Yeah. Thank you, everyone. Thank you. Can you please return to your seats, please? Because we are now about to do the cutting of the cake.
You're fine, you're good.
Nice.
Hi, babe.
All right.
How many people have been burnt on this?
Huh?
How many people have been burnt on this?
Oh, no. I don't know. It's one guy who put his jacket right on.
Just imagine it. Alright, everybody, the cutting of the cake is happening. Please look forward. Congratulations. All right, everyone, now it is time for the very first dance. Can we please put our eyes towards the dance floor for the very first dance, and we'll have some quiet time to appreciate the moment.
Oh, I'm obsessed with the way your head is laying on my chest. How you love the things I hate about myself that no one knows, but with you I see hope again. Oh, I'm a mess when I overthink the little things in my head. You seem to always help me catch my breath, but when I lose it again, when I look at you, that's the end.
Well said, Reno. Everyone, Reno. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. As parents of Nicholas, Reno and Trish, we would like to welcome each and every one of you to a beautiful wedding of Nicholas and Kayla. We thank you for joining us on this very special day. Today, we are welcoming Kayla into our family with open arms. From the first time we saw you, Nicholas, with Kayla, we knew they started something very special, a bond like no other. Kayla, we thank you for making Nicholas so happy. You truly are the best life partner for our son. We also wanted to pass on a special thanks to Carlo and Anna for raising such a beautiful daughter and family. You have brought us such a shining light into this world who radiates happiness wherever she goes. Nicholas, we love you with all our heart and always will. You have grown into an outstanding young man, and we are so proud of you. To see you so happy with Kayla makes this day perfect.
I'm honoured to share the privilege of working together every day with you and Rocky. There are not a lot of fathers and sons that experience this. Cars have always been a passion of mine, and from an early age it was clear to see you had the same. I want to share some hopes and dreams from a devoted father and mother to their loving son and daughter on their wedding day. We wish you both many days ahead, no matter where life takes you. It's official. Nicholas and Kayla are now newlyweds. What does this mean exactly? Well, for starters, you're a family now. From this point forward, you'll be inseparable. Now you'll be living as a one team, a unit that will make important decisions and memorable memories together. Remember to be kind to each other, be patient and understanding. Don't forget to communicate, to laugh, and to love each other. Do these things and you'll have a great recipe for happy, long, loving and successful marriage. Now let's share with us a toast to the latest Mr. and Mrs. Kakovia.
Let's go.
Thank you.
Now that we've heard from the male version of Reno, it's now time to welcome the female version of Reno. Jess, would you like to get up and say a few words?
Ladies and gentlemen, for those of you who may not know me, I'm Jess, Nick's one and only sister. Today we celebrate the beautiful love story and marriage of Nick and Kayla. It's an honour to stand here today and share this special occasion with all of you. Nick and Kayla, it's clear to see your love for each other is so strong, and I couldn't be happier for you both. I'll firstly start off by saying, if you told me 10 years ago that I would be standing here today at my brother's wedding, I wouldn't have believed you. I often laughed and created a running joke that if Nick was to ever get married, it wouldn't be until he was at least 40, and it would be to his car, the beloved JJ. Much to my surprise, he brought home a beautiful woman, Kayla, and he was only 26. All jokes aside, when Nick started dating Kayla, his life noticeably changed, and I knew that he had found the love of his life. Nick, you've always been the kind of a big brother that every little sister dreams of having. Having you, having you as a brother has been a huge bonus in my life, and there's no better way to put it. Growing up in the Kakovia household with Nick was never dull. From letting me practice my artistic skills with Sharpie tattoos to arguments whether I could crash boys' night because I just simply wasn't one of the boys. Through it all, what stood out most was Nick's gentle and kind heart. Nick, you are one of the most generous, caring, and loving people I know. I couldn't have been prouder to call you my brother. You have always been a role model, my protector, my sidekick through life's ups and downs, and I will forever be your sidelines cheerleader. Sorry, can I have a break?
Not the dress.
Not the dress.
you. I would like to take a moment to thank our parents who provided us with a childhood full of happiness and love. As any brother-sister duo goes, we loved each other all while having our fair share of arguments. Now for the bride. Mrs. Kayla Kokovia, your energy and playful sense of humour are absolutely intoxicating, and anyone can agree that you are the most fun to be around. You are the warmest, most caring person with such an infectious laugh, which makes part of why you truly are one of a kind. I've always dreamed of having a sister, and today that dream has officially come true. So here's to Nick and Kayla as they start the next chapter of their lives together. You both deserve nothing but the best, and I can't wait to see the amazing adventures and cherished memories that await you in the years to come. May your love continue to grow stronger every day. Now, ladies and gentlemen, let's raise our glasses to toast the newlyweds. To Nick and Kayla Kokovia.
Very well said, Jess. All right, so now we're going to play a bit of a game. So this is called the Mr. and Mrs. Photo Game. So the whole idea behind this is that Nick and Kayla have to get a photo with every single table here before the music stops. So they've got one song. It's not Stairway to Heaven, it's not November Rain. It doesn't go on for 9 minutes. I think we're good for about 3 minutes and 30 seconds. So I will be calling out random numbers of tables. When they get there, make sure you jump up, all group in, get a photo, share in the celebration. Let's get this game underway. Table number 4. Well, we have to go table 11, number next. Where's table 11? Clever, go to the bride and groom. Get ready, number 7, your time is coming up soon. Table number 7, where are you? Or don't get up, yes. Wait, we are flying through this at this stage. All right, let's go table 6. Where's table 6? Is table 6 at the back? The kids table in the back corner. Lovely, lovely. Table 9 anywhere? Where's table 9? There we go, table number 9. Hang on, is that all of table number 9? Yep, we are on. All right, table 3. Table 3. Oh, geez, we're on the other side of the room now. We're in. Oh! I did it on purpose, I swear. Table 5, don't be sitting down. Where is table 5? There we go. I think we're going to have to get our steps up now. Table number 8. Oh, my favourite. Table number 8, looking gorgeous. Oh, shit. Wait, stop. Table 8. Probably the slowest table of the night. Number 1. Where's number 1? Oh, geez. Number 1. Very good. Table 2. Table 2. Don't get up. They'll come to you, table 2. They will come to you. Alright, we've only got 2 tables left, take your time. Sensational. Table number 11. Where's 11 at? Where's 11? I've done 11. Beauty, so it's only table 12 then. There you go.
What number? That one.
And the very last table, Lionel Messi, table number 10. Quick, go, go. Lovely. Everyone's a winner. Well done, well done. All right, so we have a very special person who's about to speak. So if you could all take your seats once again. Now, this person, you would have seen him today. He had the... Sorry, be quiet. This person had the biggest smile on his face as he was walking down the aisle. All right, and it wasn't Liam... it was Carl. And you will know him from the South Street Owl House as the resident singer. Now, I am a little bit nervous about what's going to happen when he comes up to the lectern here. I don't know if it will be a lecture, interpretive dance, if it's going to be a song. But either way, I'm sure it'll be great because this guy's got a big heart and he's going to express it all tonight. So, Carl, please come up to the stage. I can't hold back because I love you too much, baby. Is it too early? What can I say?
I'm lip syncing.
What you do to me?
How good is the champagne?
Thank you. Reno, we've got the same problem, mate. Oh, hello. We're on. Thank you, Andrew, for that kind introduction. Most Italian dads get the Godfather, I get suspicious minds. Kayla, is that you? That's your influence. Anyway, welcome everybody. I must admit, I've had a lot of fun so far tonight. Yeah. It's interesting how, most of you don't know the behind the scenes organisation. Now, my daughter Kayla is a fantastic organiser, and we had to decide who was going to speak first tonight, whether it was going to be Reno or the father of the bride. And so Reno and I had a little bet at the beginning of the year. Reno, you remember this, don't you? We said, whoever wins the grand final speaks first. And so the Sharks won the grand final. Oh, come on, guys. Any East Fremantle supporters in the room? There must be. Yeah, come on. And they reckon mixed marriages don't work. Kayla, apparently it does. Anyway, good evening, everybody. I have the honourable distinction of being the father of the bride. And I begin tonight with a disclaimer that none of what I'm about to say came from ChatGPT. I turned, rather, to two leading authorities on marriage, Steve Martin, father of the bride, and Gus, my big fat Greek wedding. Is that Greek? Yes, that's him. Those of you who've seen the movie know that Gus, everything great in the world is Greek. And I'm here tonight to dispel that. Everything great in the world is actually Italian. Hang on. Even better still, Australian. Yeah, of course.
Calm down, Renee.
Renee's just asked me to be careful. Just like Gus, you give me a word, any word, and I can tell you the Latin derivative from which the Italian word comes from. I don't know that one. It's not on my list. But take Vecchio, for example. It comes from the Latin veclus, which means old man. So you see, I'm a simply Kayla's old man. So what does one say at a daughter's wedding? I could stand here and ramble off all the cliches and advice that 35 years of marriage has taught me, but I won't, because Kayla said I've only got 6 minutes and I've used up 4.5, so I have. I'll just say that today has been one of the proudest moments a father has the privilege of experiencing, walking my daughter Kayla down the aisle. Kayla, you've been a joy in our lives with your cute dimple and your cheeky smile. The dimple was so I could tell you apart from Lauren, and the cheeky smile told me trouble was just around the corner. As I stand here tonight, my heart is filled with joy and nostalgia. It feels like just yesterday that Lauren and Kayla were bouncing off Anna's knees. 20 years later, she's had 2 knee replacements. And that wouldn't be funny if it was true. Today, as we celebrate your wedding to Nicholas, we couldn't be prouder of the incredible woman you've become. Kayla, you are my advocate, the voice of reason when I start pontificating. I think you missed your calling in life. You would have made a great lawyer or politician. You are never shy to express your opinion, especially when it contradicts what I'm saying. You are and have always been a warm, kind, and compassionate daughter who has the best interests of your mother and I at heart. To Nicholas, welcome to the family. You know, as soon as Nicholas met Kayla, I thought, I don't have to worry about a car anymore. Now, a lot of you probably don't know this, but I knew Nick long before Kayla did. Yeah, like most of you, we get our cars done at Car Tech. From the first day I met Nicholas, I was head over heels. What a respectful, hardworking, kind, and honest young man. What a perfect husband he would make for one of my daughters, I thought. The mullet. I had one of those. Seriously, back in the 70s, 60s. So, hey, thank you. So I did what any honest Italian dad does. I went straight to the boss. No, not Reno. I started praying, you know, to the man upstairs. Yeah, that's it. For a while, I kept insisting Kayla bring her own car in for a service in the hope that they would somehow meet. But no, God doesn't work that way. She was always too busy anyway. So how they met was nothing short of a miracle. At a friend's wedding, both of our families were there and Kayla was in the bridal party. Nick happened to be sitting on our table. Anyhow, they had some dance competition happening, where 2 people from each table had to get up and represent the table. Anyway, Anna and Trish weren't going to have a bar of it, so Reno asked me to dance. And I said yes. We had a lot of drinks that night, didn't we? Hang on, it gets better. When we got on the dance floor, they put on Akadaka. It's a long way to the top if you want a sausage roll. Oh, sorry, rock and roll. Needless to say, those of you that have seen Reno dance, you can picture what was going down. We were going to win this thing no matter what. By this point, Kayla couldn't watch anymore, so she went outside. At the same time, Nick couldn't handle it anymore, so he went outside. What transpired next is a mystery. But I think Nick went up to Kayla and said, "Look at those two idiots on the dance floor." At which Kayla responded, "Yeah, that big guy's my dad." I don't know if you've seen Nick when he gets that look. He goes, "No way, that other guy's my dad." It was a match made in heaven. So marriage is not just the union of two people, but two families. To Reno and Trish, thank you for bringing up such a fine young gentleman in Nicholas. All of you that know Reno and Trish would agree that they are two of the nicest people you would ever want to meet. Reno, thank you for teaching me how to grow 10-inch garlic pieces. There, that's a fantastic crop this year. And how to use a spanner. Which way's off, on? Anyway, doesn't matter. Trish, thank you for all your help in the arrangements for both the engagement and for tonight. You and Anna make a great team. To Nicholas, thank you for asking my daughter Kayla's hand in marriage. As I said earlier, you are a genuine, patient, kind, honest, and hardworking young man, and I'm very proud to have you as my son-in-law. If I was to give you any advice about marriage and life with Kayla, it would be three words: keep the faith. And that you'll need all of those qualities and virtues that I just mentioned. And if that doesn't work, don't forget Kayla practices martial art of Muay Thai, so run really fast. To Nicholas and Kayla, as your parents, we are honoured to stand by your side today and give you our blessing. We both want you to know how much you are loved and cherished. Our hearts are filled with pride as we witness the beautiful couple you have become. And we pray that your marriage will be filled with happiness, love, and adventure. I finally want to end this speech with an Italian blessing for the bride and groom. To Nicholas and Kayla, may your married life be like good wine, tasty, sharp, and clear. And like good wine, may it improve with every passing year. May God be with you and bless you. May you see your children's children. May the wind be always at your back. May the warm rays of the sun fall upon your home. And may love and laughter light your days and warm your heart and home. Congratulations to Nicholas and Kayla. We love you both.
Beautiful guy.
Have we got everyone here? Liam? You made it.
It's gold plated. It's gold plated.
All right, everyone, I hope you all enjoyed your mains. Bit of a hush. So, all right, so before I introduce the next person that is about to speak, I feel like there's a very special lady in the room tonight that I just have to acknowledge. Now, this person is the sort of person you will meet her. She will give you butterflies, she will make you feel amazing. I remember the first time that I met her, it was awesome. We bonded, it was great, you know, and she just is a shining light to everyone she meets, and you got to see it all tonight. So Lauren, please get up and say a speech.
Thank you. Is it working? Ah, oh, it is. Okay. Good evening, everyone. First things first, congratulations on making the cut to the beautiful wedding of Kayla and Nicholas. No, but before I do begin, can we take a moment to appreciate how incredible our bride and groom look tonight and the outstanding job they've done today? For those who don't know me and haven't figured it out yet, I'm Lauren, Kayla's twin sister. Today marks yet another special moment in our 28-year journey as I stand proudly beside her as our maid of honour, celebrating this milestone I never thought would come. It's fair to say I've known Kayla the longest, and even though I can't exactly recall the day we met, all I know is I don't remember a day without her. Now, according to Google bridesmaid speeches, this is the part where I'm supposed to share funny, embarrassing, light-hearted stories about Kayla. So please, bear with me. As you can see, I would be here forever, and I wouldn't know which ones to choose from. So I thought I'd do something a little different and answer the same many questions we have been asked and still to this day get asked as twins. Are you identical or fraternal?
Well.
For 27 and a half years, we answered this question as fraternal. But in early January of this year, we thought it'd be fun to take a monozygous test and found out we're in fact 99.999999998106% identical. Do you have the same personality and like the same things? Far from it. But we've always found a way to balance our differences and make it work. Growing up, we would barter and make deals with each other. I would offer Kayla 15 minutes of playing with dolls, as long as she would kick the footy with me after. And most of the time, she followed through. Who is the evil twin? Let's see. Kayla once thought it'd be a great idea to turn on the bath jets while my head was laying close by, resulting in my hair getting sucked into the drain and almost drowning. Another time, she accidentally punched me in the face, going through multiple tissue boxes and a quick trip to the hospital as my nose wouldn't stop bleeding. Along with those eyes and cheeky smile, you can't but help answer this question as Kayla. How do your parents tell you apart? I believe you can only ask my mother this question, as Dad still gets this wrong from time to time. Do you ever switch places or pretend to be the other to trick people? How are you doing, Lauren? You enjoying your night? Just kidding. That would be the ultimate stitch up, and I wouldn't put it past us. Have you ever liked or dated the same person? Well, thankfully, we've never had that issue, all thanks to our differences. Did you ever get up to trouble together? I think Mum and Dad knew from an early age this would be the case, when at 2 years old we climbed up onto Mum's tall boy and took her sleeping pills. And that was just the beginning. It is still not wise to leave us both unattended with a bottle of red, especially on a Sunday night. And a million-dollar question. What is it like being a twin? There are so many ways I could answer this question, but this is the best way I can put it. People spend a lifetime searching for their soulmate. I was lucky enough to be born with mine. It's a sleepover with your best friend that has no expiration date. It's someone who knows you better than you know yourself on your darkest days, and it's hands down the most affordable therapy out there. Kayla. You were the first to show me what real, true, unconditional love is. Being twins, yet being so different, you've never failed to show up, have my back, and support me in every walk of life. but that's just a testament to your character. You are the most resilient, kind, compassionate, and genuine human being I know. You're the glue that holds many together and the very reason why you are so loved. Also the reason why your bridal party is so big. Honestly, I wasn't sure that anyone could meet the high standards and expectations I held for your love. But that all changed in March 2020, and the name Nicholas Kakovia will become very familiar in our vocabulary. Now, Nick hasn't exactly always been a stranger to us, as Dad mentioned earlier. He and Reno have been our family mechanic for years and years prior. Now, as Dad's version was sweet and cool, it all started when we were... It all started when we were at a mutual friend's wedding. It was towards the end of the night and I couldn't find Kayla anywhere. Then out of the corner of my eye, I saw her outside talking to someone, and it was Nick. I instantly knew what was going on. So protective mode kicked in and I walked outside and I said, "Hello, Kayla, get inside." She said, "No, I'm good here, thanks, Lauren." I said, "Kayla, Mum wants to talk to you, you need to come inside, like, come on." She said, "No, I'm good here, thanks, Lauren." Now, at this point, poor Nick looked scared for his life and said to Kayla, "Maybe you should listen to your sister and go inside." Kayla looked at Nick, looked at me and said, "No, I'm good here, thank you." Now, back then, I only knew Nick as this sweet, nice, shy boy. And in my head, I was also thinking, if I have to find another goddamn mechanic because of you, Kayla, I'm gonna be pissed. I was actually trying to save Nick more than anything. A couple of weeks go by, and this Ute pulls up into the driveway. Because me and Kayla used to live next door to each other, as you do as twins, I see Nick hop out. Now, he hopped out in these checkered short long or long short pants, I don't know what they were, this t-shirt, some dad sneakers and this terrible cap. And I just looked at him and thought, sheesh, maybe it was Kayla who needed saving. Not long after, the world found itself battling with COVID and the uncertainty of lockdowns. Yet as the world seemingly paused, the blossoming love story of Nick and Kayla emerged. Through this time, they were navigating the early and precious moments of a relationship that was swiftly growing to the deep bond we see here today. Nicholas, or as I like to call you, the quiet assassin. It's no secret to everyone here and new people you meet that getting to like you is as easy as breathing. Your instant charm, sense of humour, kindness and respect are just the small qualities that set you apart from most. You are always the first to put your hand up and help just about anyone, no matter who they are, and you always make time for your loved ones. Never change that. But above all, what I truly love and appreciate about you is how you've always respected the unbreakable bond Kayla and I share. You've never once tried to alter or change our dynamic. Instead, you've embraced it and become a vital part of it. Caution to everyone here. It is now not wise to leave the three of us unattended with a bottlerette on any given night. I am truly thankful for the day you walked into Kayla's life. You have done nothing but shower her with the unconditional love and happiness she so very much deserves. It's fair to say you have by far exceeded my standards and expectations. Words cannot explain how proud I am of the both of you. I have watched you grow so much in the past few years, not only as a strong, united couple, but as individuals as well. It's fair to say Nick's fashion sense has definitely improved in that time. Now, I'm not qualified to give any sort of marriage advice, but I will give you this. Just like a trusty car, there might be bumps or breakdowns along the way. Just always remember you have top-notch roadside assistance right here. And Nick, you're now included in that coverage. I cannot wait to watch you start the next chapter as husband and wife, and soon enough, chase around those little hairy babies when the time comes. Nicholas, I officially welcome you to the best sleepover of your life, and I wish you both a lifetime of laughter together. I love you both so, so very much, but for now, Let's do what we do best and party this night away. If we can all raise our glasses to the new Mr. and Mrs. Kikoga.
Very well said, Lolly. Very well said. All right, so now it's time for the man that takes everything in his stride. The person that will always put his hand up to help friends, to help family, to be there for them, ups and downs. It's the groom. It is Nick. Good evening, everyone. Firstly, Kayla and I would like to welcome and thank you all for being here tonight. As most of you know, I'm not one for public speaking. However, I do have a couple of coping mechanisms, one of which is in my right hand. And in order for all of us to get through this, please make sure you have one too. I would like to thank a few people for making tonight possible. To Mum, Dad, Carl and Anna. There are no words to express how grateful Kayla and I are for your unconditional love and support. Anna and Carl, thank you for welcoming me into your family with open arms. You have both made me feel like a part of the family from day one. It's a massive credit to you both for raising such a strong-willed, loving, witty, sometimes stubborn, but intelligent daughter. I'm sure we can agree, she keeps us all on our toes. I always look forward to visiting you both, as I know I'm inevitably greeted with your kind hospitality, endless food, laughs, and the most powerful and persistent offer of a stiff Scotch at Edney. I can't wait for Kayla and I to have a family of our own. And I hope we are half of the parents you two are. We love you guys. Mum and Dad, thank you for being such strong role models in my life. Your guidance and support have shaped me into the person I am today. And for that, I thank you. Mum, you've shown me what resiliency looks like. From your ability to get green grass stains out of my uniform, no matter how many hill slides I did on my knees during recess. The countless conversations you've had with teachers because of my endless rubber band flicking in class. And the day I unwrapped a homemade cutlet roll at work that wasn't made by you. Your intuition knew I sure as hell didn't make it either. Even though paying attention wasn't exactly my forte, you always stood by me, even when I gave you grey hairs. Dad, thank you for being my go-to in all things life and cars. From the moment I could swing a spanner, you ignited a passion for mechanics within me. I cherish every moment we spend side by side, covered in grease, sharing stories on the daily. Your advice is invaluable, and you and Mum have always supported my dreams. You always thank you for having my back and showing me how to do things the right way. We love you both. Woo-hoo! To our outstanding entourage, the bridal party. Table one. I must say, you all look absolutely sensational tonight. Jack, Ben, Johnny, Dylan and Shannon. Cheers, boys, for always bringing the laughter, beer and fun to this awkward and quiet bloke standing before you today. I couldn't have asked for a better crew by my side. And now for the fabulous queens of the bridal party. Ew! Lauren, Jess, Renee, Emily, Liam, Sophie and Alana. Yeah, the girls. Thank you for surrounding me with your infectious laughter, endless love and all the juicy goss. I am beyond grateful that I not only gained a boss wife in Kay, but also an entire squad of incredible individuals. We adore every single one of you. Let's raise a glass to the toast to the best parents, in-laws, and bridal parties we could ask for. Here's to the memories, laughter, and endless support you have all shown us. You guys are the stars of this celebration, and we are truly honoured to have each of you by our side. Cheers. Speaking of stars, a massive thank you and shout out to our MC, Mr. Andrew Papioli. Thank you for always bringing that contagious energy and wit wherever you go, especially when conquering the virtual battlegrounds in a cheeky midweek fortnight sesh. Yeah. Kayla and I are honoured to not only call you our MC, but also a good friend we both value and cherish very much. Cheers, Andrew. Yeah. As I stand here today, I can't help but think of the loved ones who are no longer with us, especially our beloved grandparents, nonnos Domenico, Guido, and Tonino, and nonnas Nicolina and Italia. Although they couldn't be here physically, their presence is felt deep within our hearts. So please join me as we raise a toast in honour of their memory. You are the pillars of our families, and we will forever carry the values and traditions you instilled within us today, knowing that you continue to guide and inspire us from above. Salud. Cheers. Salud. Lastly, and definitely not least, to my beautiful wife, Kayla. You have taught me so much in this life already, and you always know what to do and say to make me laugh and smile. I hope I've also taught you a few things along the way. Like you don't need to pay for air at the servo when pumping your tyres. How to do the simple services on a car. And how to change a spare tyre. All very important things you should know in life. Your hard work, determination, and love you put into anything you do is one of the many qualities I love about you. I can't thank you enough for all your hard work and efforts that went into making this magical day possible. I thought writing this speech was hard, which was stressful, but I know I definitely got the easy part. Now, while the pandemic brought a lot of chaos and uncertainty to many lives, to me, it brought the biggest blessing. Here I was, a 26-year-old man, never adventuring past his letterbox, thinking it would just be me and my boy Rocky in life. But boy, was I wrong. I now stand before you all, knowing in 48 hours, I'll be travelling to the other side of the world with the love of my life and the girl of my dreams. Yeah. Kayla, I'm truly thankful for you now and forever. I can't wait for what the future holds for us and our future family. But I guess we'll just have to wait and see. Bye. Everyone, please raise your glass and toast to the new Mrs. Kakavia.
Absolutely beautiful, Nick. I think you're media trained. That was very good. Very good. All right, everyone, there's coffee and cake. The cake is there, the coffee's there, and the coffee will also be at the table. Please have your coffee and cake, and we'll have a father and daughter dance shortly. But just a reminder, the telephone is still there. Leave your messages. People are waiting to hear from you.
Shine like it had too much wine, that's the water. Happening, everybody. It is about to happen. get excited. Don't go anywhere. Don't go anywhere. This is a song we wrote for Kayla and Nick. It's Italian, so we're going to try our best. I think a lot of you know the words. If you know the words, join in. How are we going with the DJ? We got music? We're getting there. Okay, join in the words if you know it. Marina, 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 ti voglio più presto sposar. Marina, 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 yeah, ti voglio più presto sposar. Oh, mi sono innamorato di Marina, una ragazza amore ma carina. Ma lei non vuol sapere del mio amore, cosa farò per conquistare il cuore. Un giorno ho incontrato sola sola, il cuore mi batteva mille all'ora. Ma lei non le voleva sapere l'amore, mi diede un bacio e la sboccocciò. Join in! Marina, 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 ti voglio più presto sposar. Marina, 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 ti voglio più presto sposar. Oh mia bella amore, no no mi lasciare, non mi devi rovinare. Oh no 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 no. Oh mia bella amore, no no mi lasciare, non mi devi rovinare. Oh no 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 no. Che luccia, che luccia, che luccia, Nicola ti vuole sposar. Che luccia, che luccia, che luccia, Nicola ti vuole sposar. Un giorno ho incontrato sola sola, stava aggiustando una Toyota Corolla. Un bel ragazzo con il suo sorriso, ma non voleva sapere del mio amor. Un giorno ho incontrato solo, solo, stava aggiustando un motore. Lo disse che lo voleva amare, ci do un bacio e poi lo sposo. Ah, yeah! Nicola, 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 che luccia ti vuole sposar. Nicola, 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 che luccia ti vuole sposar. Oh mia bella amore, no no mi lasciare, non mi devi rovinare. Oh no 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 no. Oh mia bella amore, no no mi lasciare, non mi devi rovinare. Oh no 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 no. Everyone join in. Che luccia, che luccia, che luccia, Nicola ti vuole sposar. Che luccia, che luccia, che luccia, Nicola ti vuole sposar. Nicola, 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 che luccia ti vuole sposar. Luccia, che luccia, che luccia, Nicola ti vuole sposar. For Nick and Kayla, here's an Aussie song. Everybody join in. This is Brown Eye Girl. Hey, why don't we go? Days when the rains came out in a hollow, playing a new game, running and jumping. Hey, hey, skipping and a jumping. In the misty morning fog wind. Oh, my heart's a thumping with you. Reno, brown eyed girl. Sing it, boys. Bye, brown eyed girl. Next verse, next verse. So whatever happens, Tuesday's so slow. In a minute, boys. Going down the old line with a transistor radio. Cashing made me back then, boys. Thinking about making love in the green grass. All along the waterfall with you. Reno. Brown eyed girl. Woo! Sha la 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 la. Not yet. You, my brown eyed girl. Ready? All together now. Ready? Do you remember when we used to sing? Sing it. La 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 la. Just like that. Sha la 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 la. What's the next verse? Hang on.
Girl.
What are the words?
Come on!
So hard to find my way now that I'm on my own. Saw you just the other day. My, you have grown. Cast my memory back there, Lord. Sometimes I'm overcome thinking about making love in the green grass.
Here we go.
All along the waterfall with you. Brown eyed girl.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah. You, my brown eyed girl. Ready, boys? Do you remember when everybody join in? We used to sing. Sha la 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 la. Yeah. Sha la 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 la. Do my dada. La 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 la. Oh yeah.
Sha la 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 la.